Hello gang, usually I have to think about how to start a movie review, but this unknown thriller, horror, comedy, parody, whatever it is kind enough to do the job for me. So here we go, I am Torstein from CinemaTerror, and this is Scream for Help.
I'm 17, and I live in New Rochelle. I think my stepfather is trying to murder my mother.
As you just heard, Christy Cromwell is a young girl who is obsessed with the idea that her new stepfather Paul is plotting to kill her mother Karen to inherit all of her money. This obsession is driving Christy to borderline psychotic behavior, as she skips school to spy on Paul and even puts her own friends in dangerous situations by helping her along the way. But is this Paul guy really that much to worry about? Is it Christy who is the real crazy one? Which one of them will end up screaming for help? Scream for Help was a surprise for me, as it was nothing like what I expected before pressing play. I assumed this would be a sort of early The Stepfather type of movie, or at least a serious thriller, but that's not what I got from Scream for Help. At least I don't think it is. While the story makes it sound like a suspenseful thriller, the execution makes it look nearly like a parody of its own genre, and due to its weird tonally mismatch, it's hard to say if this was meant to be a black comedy or if all of the humor came out of it by accident.
Mom? Cheating on you.
What?
That's just...
He also fixed that fuse box in the basement. They killed that man, but it was meant to kill you.
Oh, sweetie, calm down. You're hysterical.
Either all of the characters were supposed to be dumber than bread, or they intentionally made the worst decision possible every step of the way. Instead of making our main girl, Christy, into a charming, smart young teenager, she instead comes off as a bratty, egocentric little turd. It never feels like she really wants to protect her mom, but rather she comes off as wanting to be correct about her stepdad, regardless of who it hurts. She's also a terrible friend, and I cannot imagine what went through everyone's mind when they decided how to portray her losing her virginity. The entire setting for that is lunacy. All of this is not even a criticism of the movie, as I found this to be hilariously funny, and I did like the performance of Rachael Kelly as Christy. In fact, I enjoyed most of the performers. They all felt like they should be real characters in a real thriller, and I'm not sure if they themselves had any idea of how funny Scream for Help would turn out to be. At some point during filming, someone must have questioned the comical dialogue or insane plot twist, but the end result doesn't make it seem that way. Or perhaps they're all even better actors than what I give them credit for. The strange nature of Scream for Help might be tracked back to its pre-production. Tom Holland originally wrote the script with director Richard Franklin in mind, after they had worked together on both Psycho 2 and Cloak & Dagger. The script did not contain the comedic tone at all, and was meant to be an Hitchcockian thriller, but that soon changed when the job of directing went to the crazy man that is Michael Winner. Both Holland and Winner are great filmmakers in their own right, but they did not match together at all. Winner's take on the story made Tom Holland so frustrated that he decided to take on the director's job himself on his next movie, which would be a small little film you might have heard of called Fright Night. So without the eccentric Michael Winner, we would perhaps not have been blessed with Fright Night and later on Child's Play.
All my life, I wanted to love and be loved, but love can sure do terrible things. At least now it's all over.
I'm not sure what attracted Winner to this script in the first place, as he directs it like he's nearly mocking it. There is more violence and nudity than what the movie needed, but to me that just added to the amusement, even if it felt a bit overdone and out of place at times. The movie also moves along quite fast, which adds to the enjoyment, but I could never buy into any of the tension, and I couldn't care less about what happened to any of the characters. I just wanted to see where in the world the story would go next, and how many ludicrous plot turns it had left to bless me with. Even though Winner didn't have the best reputation in the world, he is responsible for some highly entertaining films, and my personal favorites of his would have to be Death Wish 1 and 2 and The Sentinel, of course, since I am a horror movie fan. Due to me not being able to take anything here seriously, the big music score by former Led Zeppelin band member John Paul Jones just heightens the hilarity of the film. Don't get me wrong, there's nothing bad about the score, it's just the bigness of it makes me enjoy it in a humorous way with the insanity of the film itself. His work here would have been great in a better thriller, and it seems like he himself was proud of it, as he also released it as a solo record. which makes sense when you think about the fact that they got Jimmy Page and former Yes frontman Joe Anderson involved on each of the tracks.
You did it! You finally did it!
Oh! For Christ's sakes, call an ambulance!
Scream for Help is a movie that you can choose to take seriously or not. I could not do it, and I think it improved my viewing experience of the film. It's like a made-for-TV movie on cocaine, and nothing made sense to me. That's also what I found to be entertaining about it, so if you want a sleazy 80s thriller that is either funny on purpose or gets its comedy by its own so bad it's good insanity, then this should do it for you. And with so many other fun movies I've covered here on the channel, Scream for Help has also been given the Scream Factory treatment on Blu-ray, so that's definitively the way to go if you want to check this one out. Scream for Help gets an enjoyable score of 3 out of 5. So, who else out there has seen Scream for Help? Did you view it as a serious movie or did you have fun with it like I did? And what are your thoughts on Michael Winner? I've been wanting to check out two of his pre-Death Wish movies with Charles Bronson, Shadow's Land and The Stone Killer, so if they are worth the time, then let me know in the comment section below. I hope you had fun with this one, leave a like, subscribe, and whatever else I always say at the end of these videos, and I'll see you again soon for more videos on all kinds of weird, insane movies, here on CinemaTerror. Thank you.